We're at the University of Minnesota pilot plant today making white cheddar. We'll demonstrate how your food is made and the steps we take to protect it.
The first step in the process today is to sanitize the cheese vat. This is to take off any dust or debris or bacteria that might have settled on the surfaces. So we clean that off with a chlorine sanitizer, and that prepares the vat for the milk to enter. Pasteurization is the step in the cheesemaking process where we heat the milk up in order to destroy the harmful bacteria that might be there in the milk and prepare that milk for cheesemaking. We're adding rennet to the vat. This is an enzyme that originally came from the stomach of a calf. This causes the proteins to want to come together, trapping the water and the fat and forming a gel. The cutting step is a critical part in the cheese making process. We want the right firmness when we go to cut the curd because that will ultimately affect how much cheese we get out of that vat. In the cooking step, we're stirring the curds and adding heat to the jacket of the vat. This added heat causes the curds to shrink as moisture is released from the inside part of the curd particle. Our next step in the process is to separate the curds from the whey by pushing the curds up to either side of the vat and allowing them to mat on top of each other and then removing all the whey from the vat. In the milling process, we take our slabs of cheddar curd and run them through a curd mill, which cuts them down into what we recognize as cheddar curds. This also provides more surface area for us to add our salt, which in turn drives off moisture. The hooping step involves taking our cheddar curds and placing them into forms, which then are placed inside of a pneumatic press, which causes the last of the moisture to be removed from our cheddar curds. The final step in our process occurs the next day when the forms are removed from the press and the cheese blocks are placed in vacuum seal bags, which are then placed into a vacuum sealer where the air is removed so that no mold will grow on the outside surface of the cheese. The bags are then sealed and placed down into storage for ripening.